Alright, there's a place called Kidzania.
I don't think parents should put their kids in school. I think they should send their kids to Kidzania every day.
Yeah, seriously. So Kidzania is basically real life shrunken down to kid size, and then kids get to like experience different types of occupations. And so what? Firefighters, work in a grocery store.
Broadcasting, ice cream makers, tortilla makers, paramedics, post office.
So much cool stuff. And when you do jobs, you get to earn money, and then you can spend the money, and then you can go to stores and you can buy things. And
so. Dorothy loved working in the grocery store. That's what I would have loved as a little girl too.
Oh,
like that would have
so
been
cute.
My favorite.
Dorothy pushing around the groceries. Dorothy pushing around. Dorothy pushing around the little grocery cart and looking at her list.
But then like
not
checking
cool,
out
so
and like
cute.
Beeping stuff. Oh, it was super cute. Good morning from Scotland.
We are in Scotland, and she is gonna have her accent now.
It is so hard. I start talking, all of a sudden it morphs into like, sometimes I go back to like Australia, and then sometimes it sounds like Midwestern.
I want you to say, for breakfast, Manila had pancakes.
For breakfast? No, that was Irish. For breakfast, Manila had pancakes. Oh. Some guy asked me where I was from, and I just told him I was from Scotland. I didn't want to go into a whole long story.
That's good.
Thank you. When we arrived to Scotland, we were really excited because some of our friends were joining us.
Yes.
We had our friends, Javon and Anna, who also joined us in Tonga, who also joined us in California.
You guys win.
They're winning.
Yeah.
Friends.
And this is a competition. Announcement to all of our friends. It is a competition who travels with us the most.
Javon and Anna, you're winning.
You're winning.
And they came and joined us, and it's, of course, just an absolute blast.
What's this game called? Schmuggle Sticks? So we love Scotland. Such a fun time here.
Highly underrated, Scotland. I mean, I think
like
people, no, people like it, but I don't think people go here enough.
Yeah. So we spent the first part of our time in Scotland up north.
We stayed at a medieval abbey, and it is situated right next to Lake Loch Ness, and it is awesome. Of course, we told the kids about Nessie, the sea monster, and Dorothy, we would walk out next to the lake, and she'd be like,
we didn't see Nessie.
We heard her, though.
Mm-hmm.
A bunch. A
few times.
Yeah.
Not to the point where we, like, know she exists, but, like, we know she exists.
And then we go to an area called Isle of Skye. And Isle of Skye is just incredible. And we find this place and it's called the Fairy Pools. I'm in. Fairy Pools? Yeah. Okay, and the sun was out, and it was like kind of like glistening.
So beautiful, and nothing could go wrong.
The water was perfectly clear. And you know Garrett G.
I love clear water.
He wants to jump in this water.
I just love clear water.
But I think for the first time ever, he was like, you know what? It's pretty chilly. I bet this water's freezing. I'm okay.
I'm not scared of cold water, but it was freezing outside of the water.
So for the first time, I think Garrett G wasn't planning on getting in.
Jessica asked me, are you going to get in the water? And I said, you know what? Not this time.
But he has his nice Ray-Ban glasses, I think on the scarf. And he bends over to look in and bloop. They fall right in to this water. And now Garrett's got to jump in and get his nice Ray-Bans.
I did not want to get in this water. Destiny had different plans. And I honestly, when I saw it fall in, my first thought was like, goodbye sunglasses. And then you said, you're like, those are expensive. You need to go get those. Here's where I dropped the sunglasses. You can see very clear water. There's the rocks below. And if you look right there, there's my sunglasses. Deep at the bottom, very, very cold water.
What just happened?
Where did they fall, you know?
I can see them.
What an adventure.
I'm gonna watch you.
Watch me what? Where are they?
In the water.
Oh, great. Can I explain what it felt like? This is what it feels like to jump into glacier water in northern Scotland. Oh, okay, I'm used to cold water. I take cold showers every day. I jump into the water, open my eyes, and at the same time, I feel my lungs just collapse on themselves. Every muscle in my body goes tight. I think it was just human nature. Like my body's just emergency mode kicked in. It was like, nope. Nope,
go back up.
I was like, I'm not gonna get back in this water. So if I'm gonna get these sunglasses, I need to get them now. And then I feel my eyeballs, because my eyes are wide open looking for my sunglasses, I can feel my eyeballs like start to freeze. Like weird feeling.
Your eyes were like bloodshot red the rest of the day.
Yeah. If you watch the video, you can see me grab my sunglasses and show them to Dorothy like, look at your dad, he's brave.
He's so cool. He jumped into freezing cold water. So I was really stoked to come to Scotland. Why? Because I'm Scottish. I'm a Graham, and the Graham family is from Scotland. And it's really cool how Scotland is all about their family history. And like back in the day, everybody had their clans and they stuck together. And I got this little book that's like all about the Graham family history. And I learned that we're crazy.
It's a little sketchy.
We're a little sketchy, we Grahams.
But you gotta admit, it kind of explained a lot about you, right?
Well, I also learned that our friend Anna that was with us, she's a Campbell, which is also a Scottish clan. And we didn't like each other at all.
Imagine if they could see you now.
I know.
Traveling together, yeah. Friends. The main reason that put Scotland on our map from the very beginning, when I was just a wee lad.
When you were just a wee lad?
I'm not.
That's pretty okay. Good.
When I was young, I had the opportunity to come to Scotland with my mom and my siblings. And we visited this amazing place called Gleneagles. I told Jess, like, we gotta go there. Growing up, it was my very favorite vacation.
So we arrive here to Gleneagles, and it is just beautiful. It's like 800 acres of just beautiful Scottish countryside.
Thank you.
one of the first things we do is we take Dorothy to riding lessons. And we go through these stables and they have like 50 horses. Manila says horses like fishies.
fishies.
Fishy.
Yeah. But they both loved him, and Dorothy was so stinking cute riding that little pony.
Are you gonna be brave?
Yeah, look at that horse over there.
Yeah.
Coach winds are calling and the sky is clear and bright. Misty mountains sing and beckon, lead me out into the light. I will ride, I will fly, chase the wind and touch the sky. I will fly, chase the wind and touch the sky. Our fears and bold, deep waters hold reflections of times lost long ago. I will hear every story, take hold of my own dream. Be strong and the seas are stormy.
So my favorite thing that we did actually this morning very early was falconing. Garrett's dad, Joe G, is a falconer. Garrett grew up with a bunch of hawks at his house. And the guy comes over to you this morning and you were like, oh, my dad actually, you know, did this when I was growing up. And then they just go into this like super nerdy like bird talk.
My dad would have been so proud of me. I was like, so tell me about the Cooper's hawk, the Harris hawk.
And just goes up and starts like naming these birds. They have about 20 birds here at one time, and they showed us all about it and how they take care of them and how they hunt, and it is rad.
Except these birds are living 5-star lives.
Like, yeah, they are. Garrett, you were super stoked on it. You were really happy.
I like it.
You would hold the bird in your hand and then you would let it go, and the bird would fly to a perch and then it would fly back, and you'd put like a little piece of meat on your glove and it would jump on. It was awesome.
No, that was my favorite too. I love that. Partially because if you had never had any experience or exposure to these birds, like, they do a really good job of introducing you to them, making it comfortable, really enjoyable. But for me, like, this just brought back all sorts of fun memories with my dad growing up. Very special for me. Thank you.
If you want to be a proper Brit, come to Gleneagles. And there's other stuff you can do that we didn't even get to. We didn't even get to play tennis, and we didn't even. Oh, they have shooting with
clay,
like,
pigeon shooting.
Clay pigeon shooting and those hunting dogs.
Golf.
We have had a little bit of a wardrobe update. We've needed some warm clothes. And we've had some awesome brands from back in the States that have helped support us on our way. One of them is Free Babes Bows.
Oh, are those the cute bows that Dorothy
brings for?
Yeah, they're
the cute little bows. So there's this really awesome gal, her name's Hillary, and she is planning a trip of her own, a 12-month adventure around the world with her family. And this bow shop is going to help fund that adventure for her. So we're stoked to support her.
What's her name?
Hillary.
I didn't even know that story. I just thought Dorothy was wearing cute bows.
No.
Love it. Where are they?
I'm coming.
I'm gonna get you.
All right. My Scottish accent isn't very good, but I will send you away.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching.
Keep tabs on Instagram because, to be honest, we're not sure where we're going next. Maybe Turkey, maybe Netherlands.
Bye.
See you guys.